Okay, everyone, welcome. My name is Andrew King, Managing Director here at WebSAN Solutions, and this is a question we get all the time. So thank you for joining us today. With regards to Business Central, do you really need a partner? Now, keep in mind, we are a partner, so might seem a little biased, but we're gonna try to take an objective view of this today for you because we do get this question all the time, all kidding aside. So first off, a little bit about us. We are a gold partner located, our headquarters is in Toronto, though we have locations in the US and Philippines as well. And if you haven't seen our YouTube channel, please check it out. The link is here at the bottom. And I invite you, we've got quite hundreds of videos out there, pretty much on anything now with Business Central. So as we continue to add content, quite honestly, this subject came up. Has been coming up more and more in the past few months, so we decided it's important to kind of jump in and show or try to take an objective view to, you know, do you really need a partner with respect to Business Central? So we kind of thought long and hard about the approach to today, and so we came up with an idea. Let's talk about the different ways that Business Central is actually easy to implement. So under what conditions, quite frankly, would it make sense to just kind of do it yourself? And I would liken this to an automobile, right? There's certain things when you do maintenance on a car that, you know, an owner can do. Swap out the tires, change the oil, air filters, things like that. But there's certain other things that you may not choose to do depending on your skill set, right? And there's certain people out there in the universe that have the skill set to do some pretty hardcore maintenance on a car, and others not so much. So wanted to cover really our thoughts on what we've seen. We have quite a few clients who have chosen to implement the system themselves, some successfully, some not so successfully. And we obviously have quite a large number of clients that have chosen to use us. So when we took an objective look at this sort of pile of customers, we broke them out into those that were more simple implementations and then those that were more complex. So first we're gonna talk about under what conditions is it fairly easy to implement Business Central. You could do it in kind of a DIY type way. And then under what conditions might you maybe consider using a partner for? Do you need a partner, period? And there are different reasons why you might choose a partner regardless of whether it's a simple or a complicated implementation. And then finally, what everybody wants to know is what are the costs, right? So let's dive in. This webinar today is kind of less demo, more conceptual, philosophical, but when is it easy to implement Business Central? And keep in mind, Microsoft, the messaging that Microsoft is giving the world these days is that it is easy to implement. And to a degree, that's somewhat true. But if my, and we've seen this a lot with startups, let's put it that way, that Business Central from a DIY standpoint works quite well with a startup. In fact, a client came to us this week that is a startup and they just wanted to buy a few licenses and give it a go, and we were fine with that. If the scope is fairly straightforward, and what I mean by that is it's general ledger, maybe it's accounts payable, some accounts receivable, banking. If it is or does involve inventory, then it's really just one inventory location. Don't have to worry about multi entities, definitely less multi currency with respect to that too. And why I mentioned startups before, if the data conversion is minimal, then that actually obviously makes it easier. So maybe you're coming from QuickBooks, or maybe you're completely starting from scratch, right? So it's just, you literally have no data conversion. The system comes with a chart of accounts, depending on which country you're in. So there's a Canadian one, US one, European, et cetera. So quite frankly, for someone starting off out of the gate with no data conversion at all, you know what? That's not too bad. That's not too bad. Straight up regular purchasing and sales, so purchase orders, sales orders, simple GL mapping. And what I mean by that, if you've seen some of our previous webinars or you've looked at some others out there in the universe, if you're not doing anything, I'll use the term funky with posting groups and trying to delineate some very complicated lines of business reporting, complex GL structure, then it's pretty simple to set up, actually. And quite frankly, right out of the box, you get a posting group. I think the definition in the Cronus company is domestic versus international or foreign, I think they call it. And so, yeah, you can get away with that, right? And the other delineation I would make is that if the user community is pretty small, then quite frankly, the training requirements aren't that intense. So if the scope is simple, you're a startup with no real history to bring over, you don't have to balance the inventory GL to the subledger for that data conversion and things like that, and there's a small user community, you know what? We've seen clients successfully implement it on their own, okay? Now, keep in mind, these aren't the only factors that contribute to that decision, but these are some when we really sat down as a team and kind of thought about what drives the successful, call it DIY implementation of Business Central, we found these common themes. And really, when we looked at the customers that were happy that implemented it themselves, they were more simple, straightforward implementations. And that doesn't mean anything relative to the, you know, the client's IQ or capability or anything like that. It's just you don't know what you don't know. And this isn't what clients do for a living. They don't implement ERP software. It's what we do for a living, and quite frankly, a lot of other partners out there. So, and we wouldn't exist if there was a more complex universe out there. So one of the things that Microsoft has done, which is really helpful, is this concept of an assisted setup, okay? And as many of you are aware, we are a Great Plains partner as well. And so we have a few hundred clients out there in the GP world. And the GP world there was somewhat of an assisted setup too. And so they've taken this kind of to the next level with respect to Business Central. And when you open it up in the system, you find all of these little tasks to go complete, okay? Now, the one thing you're gonna notice out of the gate is these aren't necessarily in the order that you would go to set up a company. Some of them are, like, set up my company, okay? Add users, set up taxes, okay? Set up email, okay, payment services. Obviously, migrating business data is important, okay? If you're coming from GP or SL or NAV, there's a cloud migration tool. We actually ironically covered that last month, okay? Some people don't even know what AMC is for banking. So this is a list of things, but it's not a comprehensive list in perfect order as to what you would go do, okay, which is interesting. Also, I'll take a very simple example. The migrate business data option here, okay? When you click on that, it generates an Excel template. And when you look at the template, it gives you GL accounts, customers, vendors, and items, nothing else, which is fine if you don't have open receivables, open payables, inventory quantities, things like that to convert, okay? Then this little template, which is quite simple, works great. If we take a look at, as an example, what I might need as far as data templates, you'll see chart of accounts is there, customers are there, vendors. And this is just a list of things that we use on a frequent basis, but we use a capability in the system called a configuration package. Okay, that migrate my business data that I just showed you is not that. It just generates a template and says, you know, here it is, fill it in, load it back up. It's not configuration packages. Configuration packages are totally separate and quite frankly, more complex. So when we get into somewhat more complicated implementations, and I'll quantify what that means here on the next slide when we get there, but as a very simple example, the chart of accounts is the chart of accounts. It is not all the GL entries historically that make up your trial balance. So if you're converting from an existing system, you obviously need general journals, right? You need, if you're converting inventory, you need item journals. If you need, if you're using purchase orders, you need existing open POs, you need existing open sales orders, okay? Sales orders and lines. So when I go into that assisted setup, right, which I brought it up here on the screen, and let's go into migrate my business data, which is over here. Okay, you'll see a little wizard pops up. And then I can hit next and it says, well, where do you want to import this from? Right. And I can say QuickBooks is one of the systems I can import. Again, same template, just a little bit different. QuickBooks Online, I can connect to QuickBooks Online, which is great. A lot of our clients come from QuickBooks. A lot of our clients come from other environments. But if I import from Excel, and then I basically download the template, just like it says, right? And I end up with an Excel template, which I'll open here in a second, that has those tabs that I showed you. It's just customers, items, vendors, and a chart of accounts, if you will. So it is somewhat limited in what it can do versus when you go the route of using configuration packages, which is quite frankly what a lot of partners do and what we do. Here, we'll just open it real quick to kind of show you the contents. This is what you get from the wizard. So we'll give that a second real quick to open. Come on, Excel. There we go. Right? So let's just expand these columns. Right? So again, I end up with, now this is just the GL accounts, okay? The other question is, you know, what are my valid choices here for account type, account category, income balance, debit, credit, block, posting type, etc. There's no indication what any of that stuff is. So again, you have to know a little bit. Same thing with customers, right? If we expand these columns, let me go auto fit here, right? I have to know what a customer post, what a valid customer posting group is, or what a payment terms code is, right? So all that has to be there. Now, if I look in the system, let's just close this off and go back in here as an example, right? I can go in, when I generate a Cronus company, I get things, but when I generate a company out of the box that's blank, I don't get any of this fun stuff, right? So if we go into my, not general journals, I want to go into the chart of accounts, right? I can see if I click into a particular GL account, we'll just pick something kind of random here. You can see some of those settings, like whether it's income or balance sheet, what the category might be, okay? So you can figure all these things out. There's no question. And there are a lot of training videos and things like that that show you how to do that. But the question to you is, you know, is that something you want to do for fun, if you will? Most of our clients don't, but there are, like I said, a population that does do it in a bit of a DIY type way. So are a few things covered from that template? For sure. All the field names, what they mean, et cetera, the secret decoder ring, you know, when we give our clients these templates, we actually have a very large document that explains what every single field is. Not only that, we have humans to help them discern what all those data conversion fields are. So that's why I say, from a DIY perspective, if I have no data to convert and I'm starting from scratch, it's actually a lot easier. If I have data, it can be a little more complicated. And the template given to you without learning how to use configuration packages is somewhat limited. So a normal data conversion that we get involved in is fairly extensive. Inventory valuation and things like that can get very complicated. So from an assisted setup standpoint, simple business scenarios are covered. If you have a startup business, if you have limited data conversion, et cetera, you're golden. And quite frankly, we probably wouldn't even try to dissuade you from doing DIY if you wanted to. Okay, I mean, yes, we have services to sell. We clearly make money from that. But if you've got the resources, you got the time, go for it, okay? Now, where it gets interesting is really the next sort of level, if you will. And this is where when we sat down and we said, well, we've had clients buy the licenses from us, insist they're going to go do it themselves, and then quite frankly come back very angry that they believed, even though we did for the record try to talk them out of it, they believed that Business Central was very easy to set up. And like I just articulated, in certain cases it is. But when you get into some more complex iterations of business, like a complicated GL structure, okay, and I alluded to that previously, if I need to drive different revenue accounts, different COGS accounts based on different criteria, if I've got multi-locations, if I've got multiple legal entities, maybe a complex corporate structure. Maybe some of my companies are different currencies, right? So now I'm doing intercompany. I'm doing intercompany multi-currency consolidations, which quite frankly is fun for no one. But ironically, being Canadian first and somewhat US second as a practice, we get a lot of experience with that. But that can get really complicated, right? You get into things like warehouse management. Sorry, let's see. Do we handle premium? Yes, actually, I'm getting to that. Thank you, Bob, for that question. The question was, do you handle premium services? And yes, I'm going to get to that here in a second. And I'll even show you some data conversion elements specific to manufacturing, actually, which is one of the premium services we'll cover. Warehouse management, jobs. We did a 7-8 month series just on the jobs module alone. We did the same thing, a 7-8 month webinar series on manufacturing as well, that's on our YouTube channel. Again, if it's more than 5 users, we kind of found that as a sweet spot where you've got quite a few more people to train. You've got some scenarios that might be special, so it's a little more work. The forms that come with Business Central, they're fine, but a lot of clients who are coming from legacy systems, maybe outside of QuickBooks, have maybe some unique form requirements. Their data conversion requirements might be more extensive. And yes, to your question exactly, manufacturing and service in the premium edition, outside of essentials, excuse me, require quite a bit more work. And I'll show you a very simple example of that, right? So we talked about this assisted setup, but I asked my team to send me just an example of the configuration packages that we use in manufacturing. And when you get into manufacturing, you need the bills of material, you need the routings, you need the resources, work centers, right? So if I open up just a simple example, the routing config package, that's going to take a second here. Here it comes, right? So these are the routing, basically just the routing fields that we need. What routing, what's the header that we're tying it to? So each routing actually has a different data conversion configuration package. And so statuses, things like that, you know, what does this all mean? Well, that's what we get paid for. We help walk you through what exists in your existing system today, if anything, and how does that match into what exists tomorrow or what needs to exist in Business Central to make it work. And like I said, if you're interested, we do have an extensive webinar series on manufacturing, in particular jobs as well. So when you get into manufacturing, and like you asked about premium type level stuff, that's a whole different level of configuration packages. And even then, when we set up a new environment for a client, we actually send them configuration packages that even help us configure the system and walk you through all those settings. Simple things like payment terms, right? We all love and hate posting groups, languages, currencies, all that stuff that needs to be there, locations, even how the locations treat different GLs, because let's admit it, when you get into more advanced capabilities, you might have different locations where their inventory sits in the balance sheet in different accounts, right? So the system supports that. But again, you wouldn't maybe know that unless you knew posting groups quite well. Question from Marianne, relative to QuickBooks conversions, is it better to convert from QuickBooks Online or first convert from QuickBooks Online to QuickBooks Desktop, then into Business Central? Excellent question, Marianne. Appreciate you asking that. You're probably asking that because you're already aware of the fact that getting data out of QuickBooks Online can be quite painful. I guess my short answer is it depends. Some clients who have quite a bit of data in QuickBooks Online, sometimes it does make sense to take them to QuickBooks on-prem first, and then we can extract everything much more readily. With other clients, we've been perfectly fine taking them from QuickBooks Online. So unfortunately, it does depend, but we would take that on a case-by-case basis. But that's not a foreign recommendation to us. We've been caught in that before and asked clients to kind of do a semi-conversion there. Another question. Oh, yes. So yes, Marianne, you are going through that exact experience. So yes, we've seen that before for sure. So like I said, it really the other thing too to consider when you're making a decision whether to use a partner or not, the question is asked, well, like what value do we bring? Right? And again, we're a partner, so take this with a grain of salt. But I can't tell you enough times this concept and this cliche of you don't know what you don't know, right? And if I'm buying the system today, so let's take the startup example, right? So startup, I don't have any data conversion, my chart of accounts is simple. Hey, great. But I've got all these questions about my future, right? I'm making an investment in software that, let's admit it, is way more expensive than QuickBooks, right? Probably an order of magnitude, maybe even more expensive than QuickBooks. So if I'm making that investment, I'm making it because I have a long-term vision of where my company's going. So I have questions around what can the system do for me long-term, right? I've had clients who they're not implementing manufacturing today, as a very simple example. They're implementing it 4 years from now. Maybe they have contract manufacturing because they're just a startup, but they have all these questions about what the system can do. Well, of course they do, right? Because you're making this investment in your future, of course. So what are my short-term needs versus my long-term needs? And am I going to make any short-term decisions that might preclude me from doing things down the road? And the truth is, you don't know that, right? We go through certification processes. We've been doing this for years, and have dozens and dozens of Business Central clients at this point. I think well over 60, 70 now. You don't know what you don't know. And I know that's cliche, and we get caught in the same thing. You know, that's exactly why we specialize in Business Central and not other systems, because we learn it. It makes it easier. We can answer questions for clients a lot easier when we specialize in something, right? Also, the other big challenge is that, quite frankly, you guys have day jobs, right? So you're not paid. It's very rare you find a client with a particular individual that has nothing to do. So they go off and they implement a new ERP system, right? So what we bring to the table is not only the expertise, but we force you to a schedule. We contractually hold you to a schedule, right? Because like you, we have a business to run. So we like to get people onto a project, get them live and get them into support and keep them happy for the rest of their lives. So you have to get them live on a relatively close schedule to when you plan to. And so we keep you to a schedule. Also, we will do roughly 40 to 80 of these a year from an implementation standpoint. Whereas some of our clients that we have today, and I've had this conversation with many of our customers, you know, you might implement a new ERP system once, twice, three, four times in your career. And we have seen the areas that there will be pitfalls, okay, in advance of you hopefully hitting them. And if this is your first time doing Business Central, maybe your first time doing an ERP, or maybe second time doing an ERP, it's not QuickBooks, right? QuickBooks is meant to be DIY. Their entire business model is meant to be DIY. But Business Central is capable of it, but like I said, only under what we think are certain circumstances, okay? And also, you're making an investment, right? Get the most out of it. Why would you make this investment in your future and not invest in it with someone who knows what its total capabilities are? And I'm not saying this on behalf of WebSAN. I mean, obviously I am, but I'm saying this in general, right? Us partners have experience, and some partners specialize in certain vertical industries. We do too. Some partners know more about certain verticals than others, right? So it's important to also pick a partner who is familiar with your particular industry or your particular challenges. And what you'll find is when you're picking the right partner, we'll actually tell you what your challenges are even before you do, right? So it's very interesting when when we get into conversations with clients who are looking at a solution with us, and we've got experience in that industry, we find ourselves telling them their problems before they even get a chance to tell us their problems. Another real question coming in. Andrew, generally, what are the signs for when you should transition from QuickBooks to Business Central? Is there any recommendation based on annual sales or company size? Will, thank you for asking that. That's a fantastic question. To be frank with you, we have seen clients migrate from QuickBooks when they were 2 million in size, and I've seen clients get up to north of 60 million in size and stay with QuickBooks. Now, for the record, the customer that was on QuickBooks at $60 million, complete train wreck as far as their financial operations. Because QuickBooks, as you know, is not a fully auditable financial system. It's just sort of a bookkeeping system. So generally speaking, revenue is one metric. I would say, when you're getting close to leaving the single digit millions in revenue, it's time to look at something a bit more robust. Your banks, investors, things like that, if you have them, would probably look to that. Secondary, though, or maybe even more important, is it's about your business process, right? So let me take a simple example from the world of professional services, right? If you're a professional services company, we're a professional services company, you're going to get into things like work in process, deferred revenue, accruals, and fun things like that. Generally speaking, when we find a client in professional services who's getting up there in the single digit millions of revenue, they're starting to track a lot of stuff on Excel. It's getting really complicated. There's spreadsheets flying everywhere. So it's probably time to make an investment in a system that can do that stuff automatically. If you look at manufacturing, we get in with clients who are planning their entire supply chain on spreadsheets. And quite frankly, we've even seen clients develop entire MRP-based spreadsheets and really complex macros and stuff to do all this. But if the one person who built all the macros and spreadsheets leaves, quits, or wins the lottery, the whole company falls apart. So there's also, succession planning and other things that go into making your company more robust. So there's no single answer for when you should look to get off QuickBooks, but it's definitely, I would be proactive about it rather than reactive. And we've seen both sort of ends of the spectrum, if you will. And those clients that grew in the tens of millions to then wait to get off QuickBooks really had some serious challenges. When they acquire a company or a company looks to acquire them, I guess, is the better example. There's some really big control problems with QuickBooks when it gets to that level. So hopefully my answer helped. We really see all types. You've got clients that just want shiny objects, right? So they want the newest, shiniest thing, and maybe that's why they pick Business Central. Others are a bit more strategic about it, and they have a plan. They might talk to us about Business Central today, but they have a plan to stay on QuickBooks till they get to like 3, 4, or 5 million, and then they're going to come back and revisit. But they know what capabilities they're looking for down the road, and they're okay with handling things on spreadsheets, sort of in the beginning, which is totally natural, right? You're not going to make a significant investment in ERP out of the gate, unless you really have to. Some companies do, some companies don't. But hopefully, Will, that was a helpful answer. But we do see clients definitely wait too long to get out of QuickBooks for sure. And QuickBooks isn't the only one. I think it was Sage 50, used to be called Simply Accounting. That's kind of the other example. Again, simple, made DIY, made for that kind of lower end of the market, if you will, and companies starting off, and its price point reflects that for sure. Another question? Oh, you're welcome, Will. No problem. Funny enough, I make that point here in the last bullet. Business Central isn't QuickBooks, right? So we'll get clients who will come to us. They'll get onboarded, they go live, and we'll have the AP person say, "Well, can I just delete that entry?" Well, no, like you can't do that anymore. It's a fully auditable ERP accounting system, right? So that is, quite honestly, with people coming from QuickBooks and even Sage 50, it is a challenge because you can't just delete stuff if you screw it up. You take the example in distribution. If I've bought something using, say, FIFO cost, and I've maybe used it in manufacturing something, and then I shipped that thing out, and for whatever reason, the cost was completely wrong. Well, that's not an easy fix, right? Because guess what? It's an inventory accounting system versus in QuickBooks. You just go, "Oh, yeah, delete the invoice, repost it. We're good. No issues," right? So there definitely are some challenges that come with getting into an ERP system. And quite frankly, as an organization, you need to be more mature to get into that for sure. And we've, like I said, we've seen all kinds, can definitely help you make that decision. Yes, we want to sell you stuff, but we want to make sure it's the right decision for you too, for sure. So with that in line, here's a little big screenshot of my head and a client of ours. I encourage you to check our YouTube channel. This gentleman is the CEO of The Amazing Chickpea, which is a company out in Minnesota. And he actually did a DIY implementation of manufacturing in Business Central, and then found us later on, and then paid us to kind of clean up the mess, if you will. So encourage you to check out that video. It's on our YouTube channel. It's only like 10 minutes long, but it's just he and I kind of going back and forth and me interviewing him on these concepts and in the end, why he chose to go with a partner versus continue sort of independent. And also, his choice could have been just get rid of the system entirely, but he did see some value in there as he was growing out into the future. These were capabilities he needed. So he knew QuickBooks wasn't the right answer in his example. But I encourage you to check out our website and take a look at his testimonial video. Now the other question we get asked all the time is, okay, great. You know, we've talked about the fact we need a partner. What can I expect from a costing standpoint, right? And so this is something that's on our website. I just took a screenshot of it. We split our costs up into different industries. So there's your basic financials, finance and distribution, so that's sales, purchasing, things like that. Jobs and project costing, getting a little more complicated, and then manufacturing. Right, you guys asked about the premium question earlier. So manufacturing is the premium license. Everything else is essentials. So here are just typical costs. Now, different partners charge different amounts, right? Obviously, we all have different approaches. Some are cutesy pink websites with a whole bunch of stuff there, like puzzle pieces that go together. We tend to get a little more detailed in exactly what are you getting. But my advice is take a very good hard look at what you're getting and doing an apples to apples comparison. We had a client, true story, choose one of our competitors' plans that was a little less priced than our finance and distribution offering. And then they got very upset that they didn't get warehousing with bins, pick, pack, and put away, and lot tracking as part of the offering. And so they came back to us before they had even gone live and said, you know, do you guys offer this? And sure enough, it's right there in our offering. So you have to be very careful when you look at the price tag and you compare different partners, really make sure you understand what the heck it is you're getting. But like I said in the beginning, it's not an inconsequential amount of money that you're investing in your future. So, you know, you don't go from zero to $11,000 implementing finance and get very little out of that value. You know, we do train you. We offer you a catalog of JET reports that have been quite popular with our clients, about 120 plus of them. I did a webinar on them a few weeks back. You really got to look at what you're getting. So, you know, the difference between zero and even 11,000 is a huge chasm. Right? So what are you getting for that $11,000 that you're going to pay us to implement the system? A lot of which I've already told you, but testing and training and all that stuff is included. And then as you sort of move up this continuum to more complex needs, right? So what are you getting here? And you know, do I want to DIY it? Do I want to do part of it myself? And maybe come to us and say, well, what can you help me with? Right? We've had some clients do that. Not ideal, to be honest, because you get in a situation where we are kind of waiting on you, the client, to get your stuff done before we can proceed. But at the end of the day, you know, if that's a budgetary concern, we can figure it out. But these are just typical. This is not, no one, to be honest, even buys these things right off the shelf with these plans. It's very rare. So every single client we onboard, we do a bit of a diagnostic routine, figure out what you exactly need, and come up with a bespoke proposal that fits your needs. Could be higher than these amounts, can be lower than these amounts. It really depends on what you need. We do the same thing for CRM, by the way. We sell Dynamics 365 Sales, and it's the same approach, right? We have very typical type solutions that clients buy from us. So, okay. So just want to give you a sense of what investment you'd face. Now here, I thought we'd put together some helpful web links. Obviously, we have our own WebSAN University. If you haven't checked that out, we have a catalog of courses on there for Business Central. They're all free, so feel free to check it out. We have our YouTube channel as well, which probably is how you found us in the first place. So if I think I told you last month in last month's webinar, we passed 1 million views at the end of September. So that's been exciting for us. There's also a Microsoft Learn site. So if you haven't seen that, great catalog, 180 plus courses. You can filter by the type of role. So you'll see here, this is actually a pre-filter for functional consultant. And you can have business user and things like that, but a lot of great courses. And one of our friendly competitors over in Europe, Abacion is their name, they've put together a great catalog of videos, literally hundreds of them. And they actually specialize in helping customers over there in somewhat of a DIY. So we've actually referred customers to them. We've referred customers to their usedynamics.com website as well, because it just contains a ton of helpful videos. And you know, we're not shameless. We can plug ourselves, and we can plug some friends while we're here too. So no worries about that whatsoever. Those guys are great. So hopefully this has been helpful today. Quite honestly, it was a bit of a difficult webinar to put together because I didn't want to come across as we were just always recommending to buy stuff from us. We would love that, but that's not really true. When you boil it down, there are certain cases in which, you know what, doing it on your own is okay. And either way, we're there for you if you choose not to do it on your own and need some support. So hopefully this gave you a bit of a good overview of not only our capabilities, but some things to consider when you're looking at Business Central. And thank you, as always, for joining us. The webinar will be up on our YouTube channel probably the next day or so, so stay tuned. And if you got any questions in the meantime, feel free to email us at info@websend.com, and we'll be happy to get back to you. We also have a chat line on our website. So thanks again, and if there are no further questions, we will we'll see you next time. Oh, quick question. Ah, here we go. Will, Business Central versus NetSuite. That's a long answer, my friend. I'll give you, you know what, Will, if you want to send me an email at info@websend.com, I'll be happy to get on a call with you and talk to you about some very specific examples. The one I can think of right off the gate, because we actually are in the middle of moving a client off NetSuite to Business Central, is VAT tax. In the specific example where you take Quebec, and how in Canada, so, okay, fine, you've got HST in Ontario as an example, but in other provinces, and keep in mind in Europe, it's a cumulative tax, so GST, PST. And given that NetSuite was an American-created entity, they have literally no capability to do that. So that was actually, I didn't even know that. That was an interesting find we found from a client moving from NetSuite to Business Central. It turns out I think their professional services module leaves a bit to be desired as well. So someone had come to us and compared NetSuite versus some of the jobs webinars we'd done, and it was a bit limited. So if you have specifics in your particular industry, please feel free to email us, and then you and I can set up a time to chat live one-on-one, and we can compare your apples to apples. Okay? So thanks again, gang, for joining us, and we'll see you next time. Have a good day.